Hello. Today we are going to be talking about QSPICE, a new free circuit simulator. So we have a friend of CircuitBread called Corvo, and they worked with Mike Engelhardt, the same guy who created LTSpice, to create QSPICE. So Mike Engelhardt created QSPICE, sold it to Corvo, and now they're working together to bring it to all of you for free. So we are familiar with LTSpice. We've done some videos on it, and we think it's a great tool. But we were kind of curious, what does Mike Engelhardt, maybe I'll just call him Mike, because maybe we'll run into each other in a trade show and we'll be buds. Who knows? But I'm curious what Mike did on this newest iteration to make it better or different. And so that's why we wanted to go through this video and show you what QSPICE is actually like. Now, the funny thing is, when I was looking into this, I Googled it like everybody does. And one of the top Google results for QSPICE was a Reddit comment that states QSPICE is fictional, which I thought was hilarious. Somebody is asking about it and somebody else is like, oh, it's fictional. It doesn't actually exist. Well, obviously this isn't the case. And I wanted to go into how it operates, why you'd use it, all of that sort of stuff. Before we jump into the screen recording and prove that QSPICE is not actually fictional, I want to mention a couple of key things and kind of the reason why we're doing this video. So, as I mentioned before, QSPICE is completely free. It's a circuit simulator, very similar to LTSpice. Honestly, once we jump into it, you'll see a lot of similarities in the way it interfaces. So anybody that's familiar with LTSpice is going to be very comfortable with QSPICE. QSPICE is only for Windows at the moment. So that's why I had to break out my Windows laptop. This thing is ancient and loud, and I apologize for the fan noise, but it is Windows only right now, and I didn't want to get an emulator on my Mac. So keep that in consideration. And honestly, there are so many SPICE circuit simulators out there. Why would we care about this one? And LTSpice, which is extremely popular, made by Mike, the same guy, you may think, why do we need a different version? So the biggest differences that QSPICE offers is that it has a model generator, so you can very quickly create a semiconductor model directly from a data sheet. So you can use a semiconductor from any manufacturer. LTSpice, they basically limit it to the Linear Technologies, which is now defunct, or Analog Devices, which bought Linear Technology. And that was really the only models that they had freely available. And it was difficult, or it is difficult, to create new semiconductor models. So they have a model generator in here. And of course, they have Corvo semiconductor devices in here as well. But if you want to use anybody else's, there's a model generator that can quickly create that. And I'm talking about it. We're not going to go over that today. I'm hoping to do another video later to show how to use that model generator, but we're not going to today. Another big benefit of QSPICE on paper is that it's better at digital logic. So you can actually integrate Verilog directly into a design. So LTSpice is very analog focused, which makes sense. Linear Technologies was very analog and it got bought by Analog Devices. So it makes sense that the LTSpice was very analog, whereas this is not only analog, but also very digital friendly. And then finally, it has an updated engine that's supposedly better at handling nonlinear circuits and makes simulations run significantly faster. So that is the why on paper we should be looking at QSPICE and why we should be giving it a chance. And frankly, if you're not deeply invested in LTSpice, this might be something that works better for you. We'll go through and you can make a decision. So now I won't go through details on the installation because it's quite straightforward. You just go to Corvo's website, provide your information, and then they send you a link to the download installer. So it took only a couple of minutes. Email came through, no problem for me. Wasn't a big deal. It is Windows only again, which was something because I had to get my email on this machine. But there shouldn't be any issues with downloading and installing. It's very straightforward. But if you do encounter any issues, consider checking out some messaging boards. You can go to the CircuitBread Discord to ask questions, or you can reach out directly to Corvo. So with all of that, now we're ready to jump in. So I'm going to turn on the screen recorder, and then we're going to go through what this looks like, and then do a very simple project, and then run through a more complicated project, just to show you what can happen. All right, so when you open this up, you get this screen, a big empty space, and some stuff over here that if you're not familiar with a SPICE simulator is going to be a little bit intimidating, but really should not be. So you can come and open this and look at whatever you've got. It's really quite straightforward. This area is where you're going to be building your schematic. This is your main working space right here. These are the symbols that you can add. As I mentioned earlier, Corvo has some of their parts in here that you can just click and drop in there. And then they also have some digital or analog right there. Got some analog parts right there. Got 555 in there. And then you've got some of your digital, like D flip-flop, JK flip-flop, all that sort of stuff, your gates. So again, this is a little bit more digital friendly. Now the built-in symbols, this is where you're gonna be getting your more common devices that you're gonna use on your normal quote unquote simulations, where, as you can see, current dependent current source, current dependent voltage source, stuff like that. Basically JFET, whatever you want that doesn't have all of the details that you'd get from a true device where it has more of the real life parameters in here. So these are your more ideal symbols here that don't have all of the real life parameters in there. You also have your different things up here. File, you can do a new schematic, symbol, ASCII file. Here's that model generator I was talking about. So you can go in here, diode, JFET, MOSFET, go through. Again, I'm hoping to do that later, but not in this one. And then you've got edit, where you see a lot of the commands that you're gonna be using quite frequently. And then also their keyboard shortcuts. If you are familiar with LTSpice, it's the same in QSPICE where there's a lot of keyboard shortcuts. So the more familiar you get with this, the faster things go, because you can just hit the numbers or the letters that are exactly what you need. And some of them make a lot of sense, like place, text, T, net name, N, ground, G, wire, W. It makes a lot of sense. So it's pretty straightforward. And then if you have anything that you don't know exactly what to do, not only do you have these things up here, but you can go into the main area and just right click, and it gives you a lot of those same options right here. So again, when you first open this up, it might be intimidating, like, oh, I got a lot of blank space, a lot of stuff on the left side that I don't really know what's going on. But we can just right click and see some of these more basic functions that you need. Let's actually now create something. So we can very quickly, and this is where it's fun, you can also type different letters. So you hit M, that's MOSFET. Oh, R is resistor, L is inductor, D is diode. So again, as you get to use these more, you'll see that they're very intuitive, even though sometimes you may think, oh, okay, I thought this was gonna be this, but it's not. So let's just do a very quick resistor. Let's see. I'm just using my mouse to scroll out so I get a little bit more space there. And then I'm gonna escape. So like with any piece of software, I highly recommend you just kind of jump in and start clicking around, click on things when you're using the shift key, the control key, see what it does, get more comfortable with it, and then you'll figure things out. But with that, let's just drop another resistor in here, and then we can even go over to our sources. So let's see, what do we want? Do we want a current source or voltage source? Well, if I just hit V, that'll give me a voltage source. And then I use W to give me a wire. Well, let's hook these resistors up in parallel. And then we will go down and add a ground, because one thing I've learned in any of these spice things, if you don't have a ground, the simulator gets really angry with you. And please, no judgment on how I do this. I'm very self-conscious about my ugly circuits. I'm just trying to show how it works, okay? All right, so we have all of these things. Now you can go in and change the value. Like, let's just call this 2 volts. Let's call this 1,000 ohms. Let's call this 10,000 ohms, just like that. So now we have our circuit. It is a beautiful circuit. It is very, very beautiful. Now, if you're familiar with spice simulators, you need to know what the parameters of the simulation are. So with this, we do our text, and we type our text in. And we have a dot, well, let's just do a transient, whether or not it makes sense. And even though this is a DC circuit, I'm just gonna do a 5 microsecond simulation here. So let's click run and see what happens. See if I screwed something up. Moment of truth. Oh, hey, it says it took 1/20th of a second, and now it gives me a blank screen. Excellent. That is exactly what I want. Now from here, I can graph my voltage. So V1 is going to give me 2 volts. which makes sense because that's exactly what I said with my voltage right there. But let's see what our current is through R2 and R1. And so now you're seeing some different values over here on the right. So when you're looking at this, you can of course change the range. You can zoom in if there was something interesting to look at, which there will be when we do another demo here really quick. But you just select that and it pops into that certain area. It's really not a big deal. Okay, I know that was extremely simple, but that's all I wanted to do for us creating our own. Now you see what it's like from beginning to end on a very, very simple circuit. Now let's just close this really quick and let's do a real circuit. So they've got some demos here. I love a good demo. So we'll open up the audio amplifier. Sounds good. Let's wait a moment for this to pop up. Okay. Now, as you can see, this is a bit more complicated than what I had. We've got all sorts of diodes, BJTs. We got a capacitor in there. We've got just a ton of stuff, a sinusoidal wave input. And then you'll notice how I did the dot tran for the transient review and then 3 milliseconds. They've got that as well. And also they said, hey, let's plot the voltage output, which is right here. And then it's basically, so instead of having to click around, if you know exactly what you care about, you just run this and it gives you your results. You can see all the model information here on the right. So this one actually is way, way more complex than the one we just did. It is very, very interesting. And you also see the net naming, negative, out, positive, and then you have your positive, negative right here. So that keeps it a little bit cleaner. And so this is a really fun one to just kind of see what it is capable of versus the very, very simple circuit that I just did. So let's play with this. Let's run the simulation. And again, this is an ancient computer. Let's see how long it takes. Okay, it said about 3 seconds. That felt faster than 3 seconds, but that's what it said. And this is what our Vout looks like. You get this nice, beautiful +4 to -4 volt sinusoid output. But what if you're like, oh, this isn't exactly what I want? You just, again, go and click wherever you want. And then, all right, at this point, you get a slightly shifted downward voltage output. And that just makes life so much easier. I love on the Discord channel, we get a lot of people. There's one user, I can't remember his name off the top of my head, that he is so good at these SPICE simulators. When somebody asks a question, he just whips it out, says, here's the simulation, and it's great. And that is QSPICE. I mean, that was extremely high level. Obviously, there's a lot more you can do with it, but hopefully now that gives you enough to feel comfortable just kind of jumping in and starting to explore on your own. As far as I can tell, it's simply a newer, faster option of LTSpice or some other SPICE simulator. It has a slightly cleaner interface and it is still free, which is very beneficial to me. But if you have any comments or thoughts on this based either on the video or on your own personal experience with QSPICE, please let me know down in the comments below. I would love to hear them. As it is, if you did find this video interesting or helpful, give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and we will catch you in the next one. Take care. We hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Did you know that CircuitBread.com has other useful engineering content? In addition to many other features, we have study guides that cover a wide variety of engineering topics at a high level, with equations and diagrams to make it easy to quickly review and reference. Go check them out!